Hello guys, welcome to VSDC Troubleshooting, volume number 5. Today we are going to address video preview lagging. When you are working with high quality footage, lagging is expected, even if you have a decent machine, let alone low-spec computers. To help you with that pain point, we've added a few more tools, starting version 6.4.5. If you are using version 6.4.2 or earlier, please check out the tutorial on skipping frames during the preview, but we also recommend you upgrading the editor whenever you have a chance. Now let's go ahead and see how you can improve the preview quality. If your video playback is choppy, we suggest checking the basic settings. Go to Options in the top right corner, click Player Options and find the Skipping Frames menu. Don't worry, it will not affect the output quality in any way, but it will reduce your computer load. There are three modes available for you here. Don't skip frames, skip every second frame, skip two frames. Try switching between them and checking the result to see which mode works best for you. Now, the following step is to disable image processing with subpixel accuracy. You'll notice this option right below the Skipping Frames menu. Check this box to reduce the usage of computer resources and speed up the preview even more. At this point, you can also lower the video preview quality using the drop-down menu below the preview window. If you don't see the difference and the preview is still lagging, let's explore other opportunities. Go back to the Options menu and select Acceleration Options. You'll notice the list of acceleration options applied during the editing process. By changing some of them, you might be able to achieve significant improvement. First, find the parameter named Use Video Pre-reading. When you open the drop-down menu, there are three options here. Don't use multi-core processing, always use multi-core processing, use multi-core processing only for hardware decoding. This feature allows for reading the video and decoding simultaneously. If you are running a low-end PC, it's always better to switch to Don't use multi-core processing. The other two options may improve playback and rendering depending on the processor load. Next, the Proxy for Preview option allows you to create a lower resolution copy of your media to increase playback and overall editing speed. If you also check the box named Optimize Project Before Preview, the program will open the media content used in your project before the preview. We recommend disabling this option if you are working on a big project. Otherwise, you may see hiccups when the playback reaches transitions between files on the timeline. The next option is called Close Video Decoder as Object is Inactive. Enable it to reduce your PC memory usage. All these options may help you increase the playback and software speed, but there is a tricky part. Since every PC setup is different, there is a no one-size-fits-all combination of settings. You'll need to find what works for you by trying and testing. Alright, let's get to the best part. Hardware acceleration for video decoding. First things first, we do not recommend using it on low-end computers. So, hardware acceleration for video decoding is disabled by default, but you can manually enable it. Hardware acceleration options can be very helpful for those working with HD videos. When they are enabled, VSDC treats HD and 4K files using the capacity of the video card. When you check this box, the program automatically selects the type of hardware decoder suitable for your PC. However, you can manually select another decoder and change the resolution if you want to. For instance, NVIDIA hardware and Intel hardware are the fastest hardware codecs that work with the entire image. It means that acceleration is simultaneously applied to all the files used in your project. These codecs are supplied by the manufacturers, so the newer your processor and the video card are, the faster these hardware codecs will work. In addition to hardware codecs, you will find the following hardware accelerators available: DirectX, Direct3D, CUDA HW, They use a software decoder that decodes only those parts of the project, video or image that need to be accelerated. This feature significantly improves the performance speed compared to the speed provided by Intel and NVIDIA alone. Note that those three software decoders we've just reviewed are most helpful when you are working with a project that contains a lot of effects. Users with the AMD APU and AMD graphics cards should select DirectX and Direct3D. DirectX is almost always faster than Direct3D, so consider choosing it whenever possible. CUDA is an NVIDIA technology that makes programming on a graphics card easier. It allows your GPU to enable parallelization and optimize the usage of PC resources to achieve the best performance. Note that you can apply hardware acceleration to each file individually in the Properties window. If you are using the VSDC Pro version and NVIDIA hardware acceleration at the export stage, select the NVIDIA hardware for video decoding. Otherwise, the program will use the software decoder and your video card will not be fully loaded during the export. In case you are not pleased with the results and you want to retrieve the program settings from the previous version, VSDC 642, follow these steps. Open the Options menu. Go to the Acceleration options. Change Use Video Pre-reading to Don't Use Multi-Core Processing. Set the proxy for preview and export to original. Click OK. And this is it. If your video is still lagging during the preview, feel free to contact us via email. You can always send us your project by using the packing option or provide us with the full information about your PC specs, and we will help you fine-tune VSDC for the best results. Leave a comment below, give us a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe.